Section 5, The Agency of Sin, Spiritual Racism. God, like love, is known through experience, not description. In the same way, God, like faith, is realized, not believed. Religiously commandeering and objectifying God, by conditioning God through beliefs and absolutes, communicates to all those outside the commandeering spiritual belief system that they cannot access God without correct belief. This is oxymoronic because God is past belief in the same way love is past description. Christians are not aware that God is past belief because they must believe in Jesus to access God. That's the short-sightedness I keep mentioning in this book. To claim only Christians know the true God is like saying only we know what love is, or only we know which compassionately oriented spiritual path is correct, or only we have correct faith. In the same way, it is outlandish human behavior to commandeer God by saying God can only be accessed through our exclusive spiritual system. To further elucidate this, Christians believe that alternate forms of spiritual belief like Hinduism, Buddhism, and polytheism are all diseased forms of belief because they are, quote-unquote, incorrect and lead a person ultimately to hell. The Christian believes that they exclusively know through the Bible the correct way to truth and life, period. No other spiritual calculus works. An atheist's name will not be in the Book of Life any more than a Hindi. Only Christians will be found there because Christians claim exclusive rights to eternity with God. In the same way, the Buddhist is not following the correct path, and so their way will make them spiritually sick from following false spiritual doctrine. Buddha will not nourish the Buddhist because the Buddhist is as much a sinner as the Christian, and all the Christians know Buddhists do not deal with sin correctly through Jesus. A Buddhist is therefore, quote-unquote, lost in the Christian's mind. They are in the outgroup and are therefore spiritually decomposed or dead. John 3:18 says, quote, whoever believes in him is not condemned, but whoever does not believe is condemned already, because he has not believed in the name of the only Son of God. End quote. John 14:6 says, quote, I, Jesus, am the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. End quote. These are exclusive, identifying, and absolute statements the Bible claims about a person's spiritual disposition. The verses are not only based in assumption and assisting that a person believes spiritually a specific way, but they also do not allow for any other spiritual architecture. It would be no different than walking into a contract bidding situation and claiming that all the other architectural agencies are corrupt, save your own, because you say so. This is where Christianity gets spiritually dogmatic and metaphysically boisterous, because the religion has zero tolerance for alternate spiritual beliefs. Christianity is like an operating system. It has no capability to integrate any other operating system, so its adherents integrate that same intolerant perspective towards other spiritual systems, and by default, other people and cultures. This is how racist is defined in my Mac Pages dictionary. A person who shows or feels discrimination or prejudice against people of other races, or who believes that a particular race is superior to another. Now just fill in other races with spiritual beliefs and look what happens. A person who shows or feels discrimination or prejudice against people of other spiritual beliefs, who believes that a particular spiritual belief is superior to another. Everybody is born sinful in the Christian's mind in the same way that white people are born white and black people are born black. So to the Christian, sin is very matter of fact. It is not something someone decides any more than their skin color. It's just how it is. Sin is that driven into the mind of the Christian, and it is not open for discussion any more than a person's skin color is up for debate. Now, because sin is so matter of fact to the Christian, the Christian's mind becomes oblivious to the psychological and behavioral fallout of believing in an exclusive religion that requires specific beliefs. For a Christian, it is perfectly fine to tell a Buddhist or Hindu that they are going to hell, because in the Christian's mind, the only world that exists is Christian. They didn't make the rules, God did. The Bible gives license for the Christian to become dogmatic and racist in spiritual opinion because it claims all competing spiritual beliefs are ultimately false. The Christian does not believe their instructed spiritual opinion could ever be incorrect, which encourages the self-righteous spiritual attitude and holds the convert to a micronized, adolescent, conflict-oriented spiritual disposition. It does not matter to the Christian that it is spiritually racist to claim that all other spiritual paths other than Christianity lead to hell or incorrect, because the Christian operates under the edict, the ends justifies the means. Since the Bible is not interested in appeasing anyone, everyone adapts to it. The ends justify the means, so irrational, racist belief requirements are justified, because in the end, those requirements save the convert from hell. According to Christianity, the Bible makes absolute statements and does not ask for opinion, seek approval, or open a dialogue, meaning the outright claims of the Bible to the Christian are absolute and final, regardless of what psychology and behavioral fallout those beliefs implicate within the individual. Remember, the Christian lives spiritually now with as much relevancy as a 4th century Roman Catholic, and so they have no apologies on offer for their lack of spiritual development. They, in fact, relish in it. When Jesus said in John 14 that he is the only way, the Christian has no problem holding others to that same 2,000-year-old spiritual statement. This is the dominator, Semitic, Bedouin tribal mindset still alive and thriving in Christians, and it ends in self-righteous actions like claiming people of alternate religious conviction are going to hell. It does not matter to the Christian that this is a spiritually racist position, because for them the Bible is the final arbiter of human life, regardless of the consequences, because the ends justify the means in Christianity. So it is not what one experiences that accesses authored grace and eternity in heaven. It is what one believes. There is nothing up for discussion in John 14:6 or John 3:18. A sinner accesses heaven because they believe correctly, not because of how they behaved or what they merited. Behavior and merit are secondary to belief in the Christian's mind, because that is how it is in God's mind. Actions do not access the book of life. Belief merits the inscription. God cares that the person believe they were a sinner in need of Jesus, not if they sinned a lot, because all sin was long ago forgiven. All a mass murderer must do is meaningfully admit being a sinner and then accept Jesus on his deathbed, and he will not be held to account for his sickening life of harming others, because his actions will be as far as the east is from the West. This kind of gross spiritual exculpation is called peace at any price, and it is an irresponsible position because it stands in ignorant denial of the balance we observe everywhere in nature. Spiritually racist behavior is tolerated in the name of God because the Bible is right, and pastors all know this because every Christian is instructed under threat of eternal separation from God that the only way is through Jesus. So the pastor sees John 3:16 as creating an absolute situation, not an opening of a dialogue. So it's okay to be racist when it comes to religious beliefs like sin, Jesus, and hell. It never occurs to the pastor that he or she is condemning total strangers to an eternity in fire based on irresponsible, racist spiritual beliefs. Because it's all very matter-of-fact to the pastor, and it's simply an issue of convincing others in the same way. Peace no matter the psychological price, peace no matter the developmental stagnation, peace no matter the behavioral fallout. Feelings about it, feelings about life, personal experiences, personal opinion, and so on, all of these lay a distant second to the questions, Do you believe you are a sinner? Do you believe Jesus died for you? Do you submit yourself for atonement? Do you believe correctly? Spiritual bigotry is the developmental burnt offering smoldering on the altar of the ends justifies the means and peace at any price.